The right to stand up for what we believe in is as American as apple pie, Independence Day, and Route 66. That right and others is protected under U.S. law by the Bill of Rights, a list of 10 amendments to the U.S. Constitution that almost never existed. In 1787, the Founding Fathers met in Philadelphia to draft the U.S. Constitution. It took almost 4 months of intense debate to get something down on paper. And that's when things got really tense. The Federalists wanted to ratify the Constitution because they believed it did a great job of establishing the roles and responsibilities of government. But the Anti-Federalists didn't want to ratify the Constitution unless it included written guarantees to protect the rights of people and limit the power of government. Calling time out, Virginian Anti-Federalist George Mason put forward a compromise. What if the Constitution was amended to include a list of civil rights that the government could not restrict? What a good idea! With the deadlock broken, the Constitution was signed into law, and Federalist James Madison got to work drawing up the list of the amendments. Representatives from different states bombarded him with ideas. He ignored some, but included others, rights and freedoms that many Americans know and love today, like freedom of religion, freedom of assembly, and the right to bear arms. In the end, 10 amendments were made to the Constitution. They're known as the Bill of Rights. So, why does it matter? Today, the civil liberties set out in the Bill of Rights protect your way of life. They're the bedrock of what it is to be American. But the Bill of Rights is also controversial, the source of countless arguments as Americans still disagree over where the government's control ends and their rights begin. Without the Bill of Rights, how do you think the U.S. would be different today?